Now you shall have to explain your whole lifespan. What you did in the open and what you conceived. Did in the open and what you conceived.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, أخرج الإمام أحمد في مسنده والترمذي في سننه من حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever wishes to visualize the events that will happen when the hour is here, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands the angel Israfil to blow in the trumpet for the first time, let him recite, إذا الشمس كورت, when the sun is shrouded with darknesses. وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ كَدَرَتْ, when the stars will be extinguished from lights. وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ, and when the mountains will be moving like the clouds. وَإِذَا الْعِشَارُ عُطِّلَتْ, and when the pregnant animals, in particular the female camels, will be left alone. Nobody will be tending to them anymore because they are worthless at this time. وَإِذَا الْوُحُوشُ حُشِرَتْ, and when the beasts, the animals that people used to fear, will be coming in order for them to be also gathered and sent to their place of gathering. وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ, and when the seas, the places that should contain water, will start containing fire. وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ, and when the souls will be coupled by their mates, if it was a good soul, then it is an angel. If it was a bad soul, then it's a Satan that will be coupled with it. وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ, and when the little baby girl who was buried alive would be asked, why? Why were you buried? Why were you killed? بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ, for what? Brothers and sisters in Islam, the earth will shake, the mountains will be destroyed, will be falling down. Destruction, complete destruction of this beautiful universe. All the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be destroyed. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, and this is the view of the Qatada, as Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah compiled, فَإِذَا جَاءَتِ الصَّاخَّةِ, when the blast is here, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ, a person will flee from his brother, وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ, from his father and his mother, وصاحبته وبنيه, and from his wife and his children, لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه, everyone will have his own business to handle. Everybody will be just caring for himself and herself at the time. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there is a view, two views regarding the number of times that trumpet or that horn will be blown in. Based on the two verses that address the issues in the Quran. Verse number one in Surah An-Naml, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَوْمَ يُنْفَخُ فِي الصُّورِ فَفَزِعَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ وَكُلٌ أَتَوْهُ دَاخِرِينَ. And the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would command Israfil, the angel, alayhi salam, to blow in the trumpet, the people will be in a state of terror. The people will be terrorized by the blow. Here is, the verse does not indicate that they will die. Now, the second verse in Surah Al-Zumar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. And when the blow in the trumpet will be here, then the people will die except those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills for them not to die. Based on those two verses, the scholars, the eminent scholars of this ummah, have differed over the number of times the horn will be blown in. Al-Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, rahimahullah, and also Al-Imam al-Qurtubi, rahimahullah, with the view that it will be only two blows in the trumpet. And they base this on a hadith that is recorded by Imam al-Bukhari wa Muslim, hadith Abi Hurairah, radiyallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بَيْنَ النَّفْخَتَيْنِ أَرْبَعُونَ. Between the two blows in the trumpet, أربعون, 40. And we will quote this hadith, inshallah, earlier, once we talk about the resurrection. Now, what al-Qurtubi rahimahullah said, he said, فَزَعًا فَزَعًا ثُمَّ مَاتُوا. They were terrorized, 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 and then they died. And they also based this on a hadith that is in Sahih al-Imam al-Bukhari wa Muslim, hadith Abi Huraira, radiyallahu anh, that talked about how quick the people will die after they already see the events of the destruction of this world. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talked about two individuals selling and buying a piece of clothes one another, so he will be unfolding it and showing it to the buyer, but he will have no time to sell it from to him. Also, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talked about a person milking his sheep and his animals, but yet he will not have enough time to drink what he milked. So, based on that view, we have Al-Imam Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, Al-Hafidh Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, the author of the tafsir, and also Shaykh al-Islam, Tayyib Allahu Thara, Ibn Taymiyyah, they are with the view that there are three blows in the trumpet. But wallahu a'lam, the view of Al-Qurtubi and Ibn Hajar, inshallah, based on this, we will explain the inevitable journey, inshallah. But if you read in other books somewhere that they are three blows in the trumpet, then you understand where the difference comes from. Brothers and sisters in Islam, what is the horn? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, and the hadith is narrated by Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, fil Musnad and Sunan Abi Dawood. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, As-suru buqun yunfakhu fi, is a horn that will be blown in. Who is Israfil? Israfil alayhi salam is an angel whose job is to blow in the trumpet. That's all what he has to do. Like Jibril alayhi salam, an angel who's in charge for revelation, like Mikael alayhi salam, he's in charge for the provision of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in earth. Like Malakul Maut, the angel of death, he's in charge for taking the souls of the living. Like Hamalatul Arsh, the angels who are carrying or bearing the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also they are in charge of carrying the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Israfil alayhi salam is in charge, his job is the buq, is the trumpet, and to blow in the trumpet. Now the Prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, told us that there are people who will be exempt from that terror, or from that shock, or from that blast. فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. There is people who are exempt here in the verse, except those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills them not to be shocked by the blow in the trumpet. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and by the way, the views of the scholars are tremendous in this area. Some of them said it is the angels, like Ibn Hazm. Some of them said specific angels, like the angels that I named earlier, Jibril, Mikael, the angel of death, Israfil alayhum as-salam, and also the angels who are carrying the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of them said they are the martyrs. Some of them said they are al-hur al-ain, the women or the mates that are created for the dwellers of paradise. But the best of take in this issue is that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has explained for us that he will be the first one who will be resurrected. And he actually explained this in a beautiful context. And the hadith is Sahih al-Bukhari wa Muslim. A Jew and Christian, a Jew and a Muslim basically had a quarrelsome. They fought. The Jewish person said, by the one who has chosen Musa, alayhi salam. Then the Muslim said, by the one who has chosen Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the Muslim slapped the Jewish in his face. And then both of them came to the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, reporting the incident to him. And Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, became a little bit upset. He became upset. And he said, لا تخيروني على موسى. Do not prefer me over Musa alayhi salam. I will be the first one resurrected after everyone dies, and I will find him holding the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or holding or touching the throne of Allah, or standing by the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I don't know, was he exempt from the shock, or he is someone who was resurrected before me. So here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself refrained from talking about the issue. Now, another wording of this hadith that explains why Prophet Musa alayhi salam was exempt. We know that Prophet Musa alayhi salam, when he asked to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fi Jabal al-Tur, وَلَمَّا جَاءَ مُوسَى لِمِيقَاتِنَا وَكَلَّمَهُ رَبُّهُ قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ إِلَيْكَ قال لن تراني ولكن انظر الى الجبل فان استقر مكانه فسوف تراني. He basically asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him able to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah told him, you will not be able to see me, but I will descend in the mountain. If the mountain stays still, then you will be able to see me. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended on this mountain in a way that fits Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mountain crumbled and Musa alayhi salam fainted. And this is the shock. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spared him from that shock because he already experienced that shock in this world. And this is the reason why the scholars explain that Musa alayhi salam could be one of those who are exempt. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's take a short break and come back, continue talking about the events of the day of resurrection, the events of the hour. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The scale of justice will be broke before man. Now you shall have to explain your whole lifespan.
Back to the Prophet. Join Sheikh Amar in the program Back to the Prophet, wherein he teaches us practical lessons from the Prophet's life and how this can help us to overcome our challenges in the present.
We talk about the life example of the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, seeking guidance for ourselves. In the early days after the revelation of the Holy Quran, the Muslims were greatly persecuted, so much so that quite a few Muslims had to leave Arabia and migrate to Africa to live among Ahl Kitab, Christian people who followed the gospel of Christ.
Justice will be broke before man. Now you shall have to explain your whole lifespan.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome back to the inevitable journey. Before the break, we talked about the view of the eminent scholars of this ummah regarding the two blows in the trumpet, or the three blows in the trumpet, and who will be exempt from the shock, and also who is Israfil alayhi salam, and what is the horn. So now, just to keep things going, the first blow in the trumpet is to make every single living creature in the face of this earth die. And this was very much detailed in a hadith called Hadith al-Sur al-Tawil, a lengthy hadith called Hadith al-Sur, the hadith of the horn. And just for to be truthful, the scholars of hadith, the experts of hadith, have weakened this hadith. They label this hadith to be weak because in its chain of narration there is Ismail ibn Rafi', and he is weak in his hadith. And there is also another narrator, Muhammad ibn Ziyad, wa huwa majhul. Nobody knows anything about him. But I will at least inform you that the hadith is weak. But this hadith somehow details and explains what happens when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command Israfil alayhi salam to blow in the trumpet. And after the time of terror and basically going through the experience of being horrified by the earthquakes that are taking place, by the destruction of the mountains, by the basically the heaven falling down, the stars being scattered, and the mountains being moved around you, and all of this, and people are in a state of terror, after that, everybody dies. Then the angel of death will come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm giving you the meanings that are in this hadith. And he will come and inform Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, once we say that word, inform Allah, we must say that Allah already knows what's happening. And he will say, Ya Rab, everybody died except those whom you willed. Allah will ask him, who are those? Then the angel of death will say, Jibreel, Mikael, Israfil, wa hamalat al-arsh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him, liyamut Jibreel, wa liyamut Mikael, wa liyamut hamalat al-arsh, wa liyamut Israfil. Let them die. They will die. And then the angel of death will come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and will report to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Allah, all of them are dead. The only one still alive is me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell him, لِتَمُتْ يَا مَلَكَ الْمَوْتِ. You are to die, angel of death. فَأَنْتَ خَلْقٌ مِّنْ خَلْقِي. You are a creation of my creation. Ya Allah, at this time, akhi, nobody's living. Everybody is gone. Everybody's gone. هُوَ الْأَوَّلِ. He's the first. You see, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything, nothing existed but Allah. هو الأول فليس قبله شيء. Nothing came before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وهو الآخر, and he will be the last, and nothing after him. Nobody is living. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at this time will call, where are the kings? Where are the tyrants? And this, by the way, comes from a beautiful hadith في صحيح الإمام البخاري ومسلم من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will place earth in his hand. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will fold the sky, the heavens in his hand. يَوْمَ نَطْوِ السَّمَاءَ كَطَيِّ السِّجِلِّ لِلْكُتُبِ. And then he will call, أَيْنَ مُلُوكُ الْأَرْضِ أَيْنَ الْجَبَّارُونَ. Where are the kings of earth? Where are the tyrants? Where are the oppressors? Where are those? No one will answer him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ. Who owns everything today? Nobody will answer him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. To Allah, the one who is able to do everything, brothers and sisters in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer himself. I own everything now. Nobody owns anything. But look, لا ظلم اليوم. No injustice today. Yet, subhanahu wa ta'ala, he owns everything. He's in control of everything. But yet, he is just. He will hold you accountable justly. Just for the things that you have done, and he will reward you for the things that you have earned. Brothers and sisters in Islam, now everybody's dead. For how long? The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and the hadith fi sahih al-Imam al-Bukhari wa Muslim, min hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anh, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بين النفختين, between the two blows. Now we know there is a blow that will kill everybody. Everybody will die because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كل نفس ذائقة الموت. Everybody must die. بين النفختين 40. 40. Now, there will be another blow in the trumpet when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give life again to Israfil and he will command him to blow in the trumpet. Look. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَصَعِقَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَاءَ اللَّهِ. And the horn will be blown in and everyone in the heavens and the earth will be basically dead except those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. Look. ثُمَّ then نُفِخَ فِيهِ أُخْرَى. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command Israfil to blow another time. فَإِذَا هُمْ قِيَامٌ يَنْظُرُونَ. People will rise. People will be rising from underneath earth. So here is what Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained in Hadith Abi Hurairah. بَيْنَ النَّفْخَتَيْنِ أَرْبَعُونَ. Between the two blows in the trumpet, there are 40. The companions asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَرْبَعُونَ يَوْمًا يَا أَبَا هُرَيْرَةَ. 40 days, Abu Huraira. قال أبيت. He said, I refuse to ask the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. قالوا أربعون شهرا يا أبا هريرة. 40 years, Abu Huraira. قال أبيت. He said, I refuse to. 40 months, Abu Huraira. He said, I refuse to ask the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. قالوا أربعون سنة يا أبا هريرة. Abu Huraira said, I refuse. 40 years, Abu Huraira. He said, I refuse to ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we don't know how long. It's a 40. 40 days, 40 hours, 40 weeks, 40 months, 40 years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what will happen between those 40 years. In those 40 years. Which is the time everybody is dead. Imagine this. And the hadith, beautiful hadith. Beautiful hadith, hadith Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, radiyallahu anhuma, and the hadith in Sahih al-Imam Muslim, and other wording with other authors of hadith, books of hadith, that during that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send a rain. That rain will fall in earth, and it will contact the only thing that never decays or goes away from Bani Adam. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in another hadith, he said, كُلُّ بْنُ آدَمْ يَبْلَى إِلَّا عَجْبَ الذَّنَبِ. All the body of the son of Adam will be decayed, will be basically turned into dust, except a tail in the spinal. It's as little as a lentil seed. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called it عَجْبَ الذَّنَبِ. From that little tail that is in the spinal of the human being, that water, that rain that will fall down in earth will contact that little tail bone and the body of mankind will grow like al-baql, like a vegetation grows underneath the ground. Ya Allah. And that is where always you find in the Quran, listen, وَاللَّهُ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ الرِّيَاحَ فَتُثِيرُ سَحَابًا. And it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who sends the wind and it will carry clouds. فَسُقْنَاهُ إِلَى بَلَدٍ مَيِّتٍ. And then we'll take these clouds to an earth, land that is dead, no greenish in it. فَأَنْزَلْنَا بِهِ الْمَاءِ فَأَحْيَيْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. Then the earth will be given life after death. Look at this now. كَذَلِكَ النُّشُورِ. This is how you will also be resurrected. This is exactly. Because there are people who actually debated. وَيَقُولُ الْإِنسَانُ أَإِذَا مَا مِتُّ لَسَوْفَ أُخْرَجُ حَيَّةً. Difficult. Difficult. It is difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is difficult. Mankind. And Al-As ibn Wa'il came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam holding bones in his hand, crushing it and saying, will we be resurrected after we are crushed like this? أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الْإِنسَانُ أَنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ فَإِذَا هُوَ خَصِيمٌ مُبِينٌ وَضَرَبَ لَنَا مَثَلًا وَنَسِيَ خَلْقَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is something that makes Allah so angry. Two things that make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so angry, brothers and sisters in Islam. في صحيح الإمام مسلم, حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, حديث إلهي, حديث قدسي, كَذَّبَنِ ابْنِ آدَمْ وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ ذَلِكَ. شتمن ابن آدم وما ينبغي له ذلك. The son of Adam belied me, and he has no right to do so. The son of Adam insulted me, and he has no right to do so. As for him belying me, he's saying, I cannot give him life after death. I cannot resurrect him again. I cannot fashion him again. Isn't the first time more difficult? وَهُوَ الَّذِي يَبْدَأُ الْخَلْقَ ثُمَّ يُعِيدُهُ وَهُوَ أَهْوَنُ عَلَيْهِ. And it is he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who remake the creation again after he has made it the first time. And it is easier for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the son of Adam is belying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he is saying that Allah is unable to bring him back to life. As for him insulting me, he is saying that I beget a son. I have a son. Brothers and sisters in Islam, let's continue on with the inevitable journey. Don't miss the next episode, because we will talk about a horrific scene that you really gonna need the comfort of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can you imagine? Earth, by all the sudden, open, and all mankind, the greatest assembly ever, from Adam alayhi salam until the last soul born, rajulun bi muzayna, in some of the hadith, a man will be born in muzayna, will rise from earth like a plant. They will wake up. They will come out of earth. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the next episode of The Inevitable Journey, we will talk about a resurrection. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The scale of justice will be broke before man. Now you shall have to explain your whole lifespan. What you did in the open and what you concealed. From big to small shall today your deeds shall then be weighed in a scale. This shall determine if you pass or fail. Heaven and hell shall be brought into vision. Allah alone shall make the ultimate decision. To all brothers and sisters, I'd like to say, ask for forgiveness and do that today.